Hello, Odooers, and welcome back. Today, we have a very exciting topic because we're discussing manufacturing orders, or MOs, as well as the work orders within them. In Odoo's manufacturing app, an MO is an order for the production of a certain quantity for a specific product. For example, I could create an MO for the production of 5 units of our coat rack product. Work orders are the smaller production steps that must be completed to fulfill an MO, like a step that requires assembly of components to produce the final product. Does that make sense? I knew it would. So let's jump into Odoo so I can show you exactly what I mean. Let's go ahead and start in the main Odoo dashboard, and let's jump into our manufacturing app. To create a new manufacturing order, all I have to do is go to the operations menu here at the top, and click on manufacturing orders right under it. And let's click the new button at the top left of the page. Doing so opens up a new MO form for us to configure. On the MO form, the first thing we need to do is to select the product that we want to manufacture here in the product field. Let's go ahead and select our coat rack product. It's important to remember that MOs can only be created for one or more units of a single product. If I wanted to manufacture something else, like a dining table, I need to create a separate MO for it. Now, after I've selected a product, a few things change on the MO form. First of all, the bill of materials field auto-populates with the bill of materials, or BOM, for the product. A BOM is basically the blueprint for how a product should be made, including a list of all the required components and work orders. If you already know a bit about BOMs, you'll know that a single product can have multiple BOMs. If I want to select a different BOM for this MO, I can do so by clicking on the Bill of Materials field. For example, I could select the Upside Down Coat Rack BOM. I'm not going to do that, though. Believe it or not, there isn't a ton of demand for coat racks that are built upside down. You should also know that you can select a specific BOM before a product is selected, which causes the product field to auto-populate instead. However, selecting the product first makes the bill of material field only show BOMs for that specific product. Okay, below the product field, we have the quantity field. Here we can enter the product quantity that will be manufactured. For example, I could enter a quantity of 5. Doing so would cause the component quantities and expected duration of work orders to automatically update on the tabs below. I'm going to go ahead and change the quantity back to 1 for simplicity's sake. Speaking of which, two other sections of the form that auto-populate when a product or BOM is selected are the Components and Work Orders tabs. The Components tab shows all of the components needed to manufacture the product. In this case of the coat rack, we have the wooden pole and the wooden dowel. On the right side of the product lines, we can see the required quantity of each component. In this case, we have 1 wooden pole and 6 wooden dowels. Let's go ahead and click on the Work Orders tab. Here, I can see the operations required to manufacture the product. In this case, we're going to need to drill the pole and insert the dowels. The line for each operation also shows the work center where it will be carried out, as well as the expected duration, or how long it should take to complete. As you can see, both of these operations will take 60 minutes to complete. Now, you've probably already figured out that the combined time to complete both operations is 2 hours. Can you see that reflected anywhere on the MO4? That's right, in the scheduled, date, and end fields. The end time is set to exactly 2 hours after the scheduled date. That makes sense, right? If I want to, I can change the scheduled date by clicking on the field, which causes a calendar to pop up. However, the end field will always be set to the scheduled date plus the expected duration of all the work orders. Alrighty, everything looks good here, so let's go ahead and confirm the MO by clicking Confirm at the top left of the page. Once I do, even more stuff changes. Under the end field, a new field appears titled Component Status. Since we have the required components in stock, the status appears as available. If we were missing one or more of the required components, it would read not available instead. In addition, the word available appears in a green font. This means that the MO is ready to start, which we can see reflected in the chatter as well. Right now, we have one step manufacturing enabled. This means that MOs will be marked as ready as long as we have enough components in stock. If we were using two or three step manufacturing, components would need to be transferred to the production location before the MO would be ready to start. In this case, the component status would still read as available, but it would appear in an orange font, which means waiting for components. Okay, let's go down here to the work orders tab where we can see the real duration column. This was here before the MO was confirmed, but now reads zero for each work order. The real duration represents the actual time that it takes to complete the work order. We also see a new status column, which displays the current status for each work order. The drill pole work order is marked as ready since it's the first work order and the MO itself is ready. If I click start on the drill pole work order, the real duration timer begins counting and the status changes to in progress. The insert dowels work order is marked as waiting for another WO because you guessed it, the drill pole work order needs to be completed first. If I click done on the drill pole work order to complete it, the status of the insert dowels work order changes to ready since it's not waiting on other work orders. I'll just go ahead and quickly complete the insert dowels work order as well. So let's go ahead and click start and done. With both work orders completed and marked as finished, I'm all ready to close the whole MO. To do that, I just need to click on the produce all button at the top left of the screen. Voila, the MO is closed and we've officially produced one coat rack. Not too hard, right? And that brings this tutorial to a close. Today, we learned how to create and process manufacturing orders along with the work orders within them. I'll see you in the next one.